So now that we have successfully connected our data source to Softr, visualize our data as a list and list details block, let's go through the process of setting up our users. Users are a crucial part of your Softr app. They allow people to log into your app, create an account, see certain sets of information, update and edit that information, all in real time. Before we dive into Softr, it's important to have your users table in either Google Sheets or Airtable ready to go. If you haven't already set up your database to include a users tab, go ahead and do that right now, and then we'll dive in. As you can see here, the employee list table serves as my user table. I have their name, their email, their photo, and lots of other information. So now that I have this users table set up, I'm ready to connect them to Softr. So let's jump over into the studio. So if we click into the handy checklist, we'll see that set up users is the next step. If I click into it, Softr will take us over to the users tab in the left-hand sidebar. On the users page, we'll be able to connect our data source as well as connect our users to our Softr app. So when a new user is added, either here or via one of our signup forms, a respective row will be added into your data source, whether that be Airtable or Google Sheets. So we first want to connect our Airtable base, which within this series is our employee directory. So I'm going to find it here. Then I'm going to select our table, which is, again, our users employee list. Then you choose their email field. And then you have additional options. So I'm going to add the name. I'm also going to add the magic link field and their profile picture. Perfect. Now we can see the user section and confirm it's connected to the correct table as shown here. So let's just briefly go through the users page so you can familiarize yourself with it. As you can see here, the list of all of your users will be listed here. You'll see their name, email, created date, which is the date that this user was added into the system, last seen date, when did they last log in, and then their magic link. Moreover, you have the ability to add users, and you can also delete users here as well. But again, if you delete a user in your Softr app, you'll also want to go back to your data source and make sure you delete that as well. Okay, another thing to note is that the user section has two modes, test data and live data. So if you toggle test data on, you'll see here, I've already been playing around with it and I created a test user. This is a really great idea because it allows you to create users in preview mode, which you can see up here with the play mark. So if I click play, I'm technically in testing mode. So any user I create here is essentially a test user. And this is a great way to really test your application for errors and make sure everything is functioning correctly before you go live. It's something we really recommend that you do. All right, onward with our users. I'm gonna turn the test data off. So as you can see here, our users have not automatically synced to Softr. So you have two options to add users that already exist. So for example, I wanna go ahead and add all these users because they're my employees and I want them to be users within this app. So the way you can do that is manually or via CSV. Each of these options will send an invite to your user, or in my case, my employees, with a set of credentials so that they can log in and access the app. Let's take a look at what these options are. So first up is adding a single user. So if we head over to the yellow button here, we see add users. So all you need to do is add their first name and the user's email, and then you can choose between two authentication choices. Either generating a temporary password or generating a magic link. So a temporary password will essentially allow you to either manually send an email via copying the email and temporary password, which in this case, you would choose continue without inviting. Let's take a look at the temporary password option first and see what it looks like. So let's say like I'm an employee that I need to invite. So my name is Lizzie and then my email, perfect. So then I click save and continue, and you'll see here the user has already been added. Now I can invite this user by either copying and pasting the email and password individually, and then pasting it into say an email or maybe a Slack message, or I can create an automatic invite. So this will send an invite to the user with their generated password. Let's take a quick look at what that looks like. All right, so invite sent. And then you'll see here that it says Lizzie LaCour has been invited to this untitled application. I haven't named it yet. here's your temporary generated password. So the only potential struggle with this option is that there's no direct link to your Softr app. So you'll want to make sure that your employees have access to your Softr app link so that they know where to go to add their temporary password. The second option is generating a magic link. Now, we've used this term a few times in the video. This is where it comes in. Magic links provide a way for users to authenticate without a password. So later on, a user can set up the account info in their user profile and just sign in the usual way. So let's go ahead and quickly see what that looks like. I click save and continue. And as you'll see here, it says the user was successfully added. You can see here. You can also see it within the employee directory. And you have the same options of being able to manually copy and paste their email and magic link, or you can just send an automatic invite again. And let's take a look at what this looks like. So as you can see here, it says I've been invited to the application. I click the link and I'm already logged in. Pretty cool, right? Now, those are your options for adding users manually one by one. But let's say you have a large database with several different users that you want to add. You can actually easily do this by CSV. So let's zip over to Airtable and I can show you how this is done. So within Airtable, I'm gonna head to my user table, which is my employee list. You first wanna make sure you don't have any empty records, which I don't hear. I'm also gonna delete this one because I think Softr is gonna notice that that user has already been added. Next, I'm gonna click on the correct view, and then I'm gonna go to download CSV. Now let's head back into Softr. I'm going to go to import users and upload my CSV. Now all I need to do is map the appropriate information. I'm gonna leave the password field blank, then create invite. Here you can generate a password or generate a magic link. Let's do magic link. Next, then you'll see the invite email here. Typically I would just go ahead and send the invite and it'll automatically send the email, but for now I'm actually just gonna finish without sending since this is just a test. And viola! Your users have been added to the user table and they've been invited to the app. Also note, let's say like we have an employee that said they lost their original invite or they haven't seen it yet. You can easily resend their invite by just clicking the employee or the user that you want to invite, go to actions, and you can click resend invite here. You can also regenerate magic links at any time, and you can copy and paste the current magic link and send it, let's say in a Slack message to your user. Now, you'll notice one thing we haven't covered yet are user groups. We're gonna touch more on user groups in the future videos, but at a very high level, user groups allow you to set specific permissions and visibility based off of predetermined factors. So for this, the very basic user groups we have are users that are logged in or all users. So you can actually direct your users to a specific page after they sign up or sign in, which could be really helpful for you. In addition, you can also do it for the sign up. This can be really helpful if you want to redirect your users to the most important page in your app so that they see the most relevant information first. All right, there you have it. You've successfully added users to your Softr application. Now, the last thing to note is that this use case is really valuable if you already have a list of users in your database. However, let's say like you want to create an app where anyone can just log in and sign up and create an account. We're gonna go over that in the next video. Let's get into it.